Done. Assalamu alaikum, students. How are you? I think you have done some of the work. Some of the question has come to me. First of all, I will explain that question. Then I will proceed the further. One of the student has asked the question of the worksheet, question number 6. I will do it first. My question is, find the coordinates of the vertex of this parabola. Vertex mean, I have told you the Cambridge will use the different word. He will use a vertex, he will use a maximum minimum point, he will use the word stationary point, point of inflection. These are the terminology he will use. Here he has used the word vertex. How to get it the same way? Was completing the scale method. First of all, take the value of x is in the bracket. Now, 4 is a perfect square. It is a square of 2x minus 2, a and b. What the value you will put over here to make it 12? 2 to the 4, 4 3 times 12. This 3, the square of 3 we will add and subtract. And this 7 will remain same. There. Now it is a complete square of 2x minus 3. The square of 3 is 9 plus 7. First of all, we will solve it this one. Now, 2x minus 3 whole square minus 9 plus 7. 2x minus 3 minus 2. Now, for the sake of vertex or the line of symmetry, keep 2x minus 3 square equal to 0. Put to get the value of x. How to remove square? By taking square root to both sides, and this step you have to show. 2x minus 3 equal to 0, and the value of x would be 3 by 2. Now, what would be the vertex point? 3 by 2 and minus 2. If you will keep 2x minus 3 0 here, the value of y will left minus 2. Now, the answer of the vertex point would be 3 by 2 and minus 2. Now, its second part even, find the value of the constant k from which the line is a tangent to the curve. This B part, equation of line. Y is equal to kx plus 3 and the equation of curve. Now in this part he hasn't used the word use the discriminant. He has used the terminology the line is a tangent to the curve. So we will have to make first the quadratic equation in x by combining these two equations. Just see, these two equations are equal to y. So I may keep them equal. No. Now we have to keep them equal to 0 by rearranging the values. Now take common. Now you will use, you will write over here, use discriminant And you should know you have to use the discriminant, it is equal to zero when the line is tangent to the curve. Now here the value of B would be minus 12 plus K. This negative sign we have to show here in the value of B. Though it become plus, then we'll open the square. But we have to show this step. Open it. 12 plus, first of all you will have to show. It's mean we have opened the bracket and this negative sign becomes plus. Yes. Now, do not open it and take square root to both sides to get the value of K. Whenever we solve the square root, we get plus minus. We get two values, two roots. The first 8 minus 8. These are the two roots. The value of K is minus 4 and minus 20. Now this was the worksheet question. Now student has asked me about the question number even 10, 15 and 16. Student, yesterday we have studied only the composite function. Domain and range questions are coming in this exercise, but it is my next lecture. So try to focus on composite function first. And one of the students even asked about the one-to-one, please explain the one-to-one function again. So I'm going to explain by giving an example to you. Yes, in last lecture, I have told you, suppose you have 1, 2, 3, a function, and the second function is A, B, C. One has the member A, two has the member B, three has the member C. It's mean whatever the value I will input, I will get the different output. Another, just like I'm going to write one of the equation, you will come to know. Equation is 2x squared plus 4x minus 8. This is y. Just imagine you are going to draw a graph. What you will do, first of all, we will construct a table. Just like in this way, we construct the table x and y. And we take a supposed value of x. Just like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. If I keep in this equation 0, what I will get? Minus 8. If I will keep 1, here 2, minus 2. If I will keep 2 here, 8. If I will keep 3 here, 22. If you will keep 4 here, 32, 40. Just
Just see towards this table, whatever the input you will keep, you get the different output. No value is repeated in this Y section. It's mean it is one-to-one function. Okay, every function has a unique value, a different one. No value is repeating. If the value repeating in the Y area, Y axis, it's mean it is not one-to-one function. It is very important to get to know about the one-to-one function, because Cambridge always asks a question of, even it is one marks question, but you should know about this one. It's better to draw a table of that equation and evaluate it. It is one-to-one function or not. I have written the equation of question number 15 of this one. Fine. Even I may proceed this question. Express this one into a plus bx form. A into I have to convert this equation into this form. My question is very clear about, I have to take common from this equation. There the common 2 comes. First take it in the bracket, the value of x. Now take out 2 common. X square plus 2x minus 8. Now 2. X square plus 2x plus 1 square minus 8. It is the whole square of x plus 1. The square of 1 is 1 and minus 8. The same steps, the same process I am following of the completing the square method. Now multiply with 2. Just see, and this is the same type. 2a 2x plus 1 plus c. This was the A part of question number 15. Now the B part. Find the least value of k for which f the function is 1-to-1. In your question, he has given the range x greater than or equal to k. Now get the squared value x plus 1 square. Keep them equal to 0. To get this the least value. How to remove the square? By taking square root to both sides. And you will get the least value of k is minus 1. This was our question number 15. Even one of the students has asked about question number 16. Seventeen is a composite function, and the B part is the range. Range we haven't studied still. Question number 16, AB part you can do.
जी
क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 एफ ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर फाइंड द सेट वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स फॉर विच एफ ऑफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन एंड इक्वल टू 7 Now keep the value of f of x. Change the site. Now make a pair. Take x common. Yes, keep them equal to 0. It's mean curve is intersecting at 2 point, -1 and 3. And this is the region which lies. So, I have already told you, you have to combine the equation. Don't put the inequality sign just like -1 less than or equal to x. At this stage, the answer would be correct. But you will find here, if this is -1, it's mean the value of x would be less than or equal to -1 and x greater than or equal to 3. In this way, you may write the answer. But better to write the answer in this form. It will not be correct in any case. No, it's B part. We have to convert it into x minus a square plus b form. It's mean here we cannot take common and you cannot get even. Just x square minus 2x plus 1 square minus 1 square plus 4. The half of the coefficient of x is 1, is 2. The half of 2 is 1. So, just x minus 1 whole square minus 1 plus 4. The square of 1 is 1 and 4. And this would be the final answer. This is even the revision of those students who hasn't attended the lecture. So, just revise this method. Now, I'm going to explain one composite function again. The question number 9, it was the B part. The question number 9, one of the students has asked, and we have to find an expression f of x giving you answer as a single fraction in simplest form. We have to find this f of x. Now one of the function has used only twice. F, again f. So keep the f of x in place of x. I have kept f of x in place of x. Now I will keep the value of f of x. Now, here there are two fraction comes. Now, you will have to separate it first. By putting a division sign. Yes, when the fraction comes, we will take the LCM. Here I will multiply with 2 first. 2x plus 2 over 2x plus 5. Now simplify it. 3x plus 6 now here you will take the LCM 2x plus 5 Yes, the division sign has come. No, the second fraction will be reciprocal. When you will convert it into the multiplication sign. It's 27. Here the fraction will be reciprocal now. No, we may cancel this one. Here you may take common 3x plus 2 left. Here 3 common 4x plus 9. This 3 even cancel and the rest it left would be the answer final. This was the problem which you people have faced. Okay, I will do one more question, question number 12. These are the two functions f of x and g of x. Find the value of k for which f g of x is equal to x has two equal roots. The given condition is f g of x is equal to x. Now take the f of x. Now keep g in place of x. This f g of x is given in my question is equal to x. Two by x. The value of g of x is 2 by x. Now take here x LCM. Now cross multiply. Equal to k. Now the question statement says in question number 12, find the value of k for the equation has two equal roots, means use discriminant.
The value of k would be plus minus 16. This was all about your composite function. Composite function has been concluded. Now I will today I will send you the second worksheet of the chapter number 1 quadratic. This weekend you will have to solve these questions, and even you have to make a practice of these questions of composite function. Inshallah, in the next lecture it will be the different one, and we will discuss about domain and range. If you have any question, then we will discuss with you. Okay, Allah Hafiz. Jazakallah.